Well, we're ending with more from our special season of stories from South Africa, meeting some amazing people who call the country home. This week, we're in the university town of Stellenbosch in the Western Cape. More than 200 vintners currently make wine here, but until now, it's largely been a white man's game. So when we heard that one of the country's first black female vintners had set up shop, we thought we'd go to meet her.
All I know is that whenever I work with wine, I get excited. Whenever I touch wine, I'm in the vineyards. I need all of them red. I don't want to lose wine, you know, I don't have enough of this. We're bottling our Boschetto. Like we're bottling in 2012, which has been in barrels for 24 months. I came to Stellenbosch in 1999 through the scholarship from South African Airways to study winemaking. And I remember when I arrived for the first time, I was like, what are these little trees, short trees, what are they? And actually those were the vineyards, you know. KwaZulu-Natal, I grew up in a village and white people, rarely, you rarely see them. And all of a sudden I was in a place where it's like basically 99% white people and then just 1% of blacks, you know. So it was a complete different environment. For me, there was a challenge of culture, there was a challenge of language. But it was one of those where, like, there's an opportunity that comes, let me take the opportunity, let me go and do something. I'll start you with the Pinotage. Pinotage, it get made in different styles. And this one is basically a lighter style. It's been wooded for 14 months in oak. We use second fill barrels, no new oak. It's more of a fruity, upfront kind of a wine. As you can see, as we're tasting, I taste with you because I just cannot watch people tasting alone. It's a sin. This is our proudly South African wine. It was a cross of Pinot Noir and Hermitage, which was done here in South Africa. It was done here in Stellenbosch University. And basically, this is who we are. I want my wine to take a person to the journey of where the wine comes from. And when they taste the wine, they understand that it's not just something that you take and mix and put it in the bottle and send. But as it happened, it goes with your emotion as a winemaker. You get excited with the bottle. From the vineyards, all the way, there's people involved who put their heart and soul into it. And as it gets to their glasses, it's like they should think of the journey. This is the Cabernet grapes. And the interesting thing is when you look, each and every varietal, it's got different leaves. And the Cabernet, it's got much more pronounced indentation if you look at it. Like, you look at that one. We're using open bin fermenters, we're doing punch down, we try and avoid to extract a lot of tannins into the wine. Basically, in terms of taste, it's like more, you'll pick up the fruit, you'll pick up that component of the wood that we're using, and a good balance in the wine. And then we've got a Shiraz. You get Shiraz that are more fruity, more, and then you get those Shiraz that are more spicy, blockbuster Shiraz that literally punches you. Again, we focus on fruit on this side. People who are Shiraz fans, they usually love that blockbuster kind of Shiraz.
Yes.
If I meet somebody who say, no, I'm a Shiraz fan, I don't give them the Shiraz. And the person say, I don't drink Shiraz because, and I'm like, okay, try this. Basically, I start tasting wine during fermentation. When it's closer to the bottling and you taste the wine, you're like, yes, we got it. It's now ready, you know. That's why I'm like, oh, now it is wine. Now it is in the direction I want. We've got straight varietals. We do have straight Cabernet. We've got straight Merlot. But, you know, when I look at the wines in general, a blended wine, that's where actually the winemaker get to play. That's where a winemaker got to do something that's going to be completely different from anyone else. my 2004 Cape Cross won gold from Michelangelo Wine Awards. I took the wine, took it home to my grandmother. And for me, that was my best wine moment. She had never tasted wine before. I opened it, I took cups, I poured the wine for her, and she tasted the wine and she said it's nice. The facial expression was saying something else. It was more like one of those things that you're like, it was just beautiful. We've got a beautiful country that's got different provinces which all have different characters.